Maybe we should. I'm gonna put that on.
Oh, yeah.
I'm gonna go ahead. Let me write that down to do. I'm gonna put it on a link on Facebook. So you guys can see what song. It's a song that I just kind of came up with, and I was writing the song. It'll show you how sometimes we'll come up with songs. We taped it. Bird song. Put a link onto it.
Well, I had a start page for today anyway. I hadn't even started one. So I'll do a bird song.
Yeah, but Bird song was just kind of like something that came up. Yeah. We talked about, like, it's an old friend of ours years ago that, you'll see what it says, but the story is that you can read what the description of it. I put it down. I explained on the description. But basically, you see how we came up with the lyrics. You'll see how it came out. It only took a couple of minutes, But it's a song with spiritual truth in it.
Don't call me that name anymore. Yeah, don't call me that name anymore.
Yeah. Because, Bo got in a fight or something, right?
Yeah.
And then Bo's black, and then some white dudes jumped on him while they were calling him the N-word.
Yeah.
It really
really hurt him. Oh, even more than the punches,
Young dude.
And I felt this song come on, me and Matt were jamming and talking about Bo and everybody else. Don't call me that name, don't call me that name anymore,
And then I just started taking it, you hear me, throw in lyrics, it's like, I don't care how many times you come in the door, I think I said something like that. I'm not going to answer the door, or how many tears came out my door, it was like that, you're thinking about it in the house or something.
That was one of the best ones. I said, it sounded like a rap video, like Little John or something in the background.
It could be rap. You could probably turn it into another song.
It probably could. I have to go back and review it and stuff because I forgot.
I haven't played it in a long time. I forgot about it. It just came up in my mind. Something told me to mention.
Gotta get new strings to the guitar, man. That's one of the things I got to do. But top priorities, man. Gotta get shit out of the other stuff.
I guess today, we're just doing, these are almost like, we could call them a type of freestyle video.
Yeah.
We're just speaking, anything that comes to mind, and it has significance,
Yeah, it does.
Like a talk show. This is how we're thinking of ourselves almost like it's a format of a talk show that we're doing here.
Yeah.
20-minute segments, an hour talk show, 20-minute segments or more a day. We don't have the audience sitting here, but the audience is out there.
Yeah.
Hopefully we'll get some questions.
Yeah, we'll get some questions.
That way we can make each subject each day.
Yeah.
That'll be interesting.
Well, I felt like last night I had an epiphany in my head. I said, I want to take off my sunglasses and my hat in one of the videos.
I should hear. Take off my sunglasses
Just to be open, and just change the vibe up, but just be confident, not worry about it. So I'm going.
It's interesting, though, it's confidence. I mentioned that last night, I think, is confidence is real important. True confidence is a type of feeling that you're not stepping on people and saying, ha-ha, look at me, and look what I got, and this and that. It's something that speaks for itself. It's spiritual confidence, That's what it's a good way. If you're confident in the right way, it'll open your mind in other ways. I'm trying to say a lot of different things can lead you to a spiritual path, a true one. It might come to you. You might get a taste of freedom, a spiritual freedom. It might come to you in a mystical experience or something like that. Or you might meditate first, or it might come to you first. But either way, if it's meant to be, it's going to come out. I was thinking this morning, I was telling him about, I turned on the television in my living room this morning. The channel was on, the first thing I heard pretty much was some church service being broadcast. I don't know why it's a church service, but it's what it was being said right as the TV came on about that no one who looks at the sky, touches the sky or the clouds, and then looks back is fit for spiritual service. You know, yeah, once you get a taste of that ecstatic feeling and the spiritual euphoria, freedom from metals and spiritual slavery, you know, and then you won't want to look back. You're not going to look back at family, friends, or anything, you know, but if you do, you know, I mean, of course, you know, maybe you have to learn. Of course, I guess everybody looks back. I'm not trying to interpret it literally, but it's a concept of that that has some truth. Yeah. You know, those particular words are interesting, you know.
Strikingly kind of angry words, you know, like judgmental, you know.
Yeah. But then again, you know, it's the truth, too, because I think in that part of the Bible, you know, I'll use the Bible as a tool here. As you see, we talked about the Gita and Buddhism in the last one. Now we're talking about the Bible for a second.
Yeah.
Like it said something about, right before that, it's like it was people saying, well, look, I've got to do this first or that first before I can follow the spiritual path.
Yeah.
You know, and then boom. Christ was saying, no, 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 just do it.
Yeah.
Well, that's important to say. You know, of course, you can always look back and, you know.
I guess I was thinking about the literal.
Literal way it was put.
Astrally going out and touching the clouds.
Oh, yeah.
You know, coming back with something wrong with that.
You know, I think it was touching freedom. That's what it meant. Touching spiritual freedom.
I was thinking a very literal literature.
You can't, that's what I was talking about, that you can't think of these Bible verses or Quran verses or Gita verses absolutely literally.
No,
you cannot. You have to use your own intuition and let what purest impressions, what you feel the truth is within you.
Yeah, I was trying to figure out what that was, man. I was having a hard time with that one.
It's very important not to trip up on that, because the truth is buried within the words can only describe something a little. The truth is buried in those words. You'll see it within your mind if you do it the right way. If you look at it with knowing you want to learn the truth within you, you'll receive the truth. You get the answers.
Yeah.
So
that's right.
You'll get that answer. That's for sure.
From mental slavery.
Bob Marley is definitely a prophet. A spirit. He's a spiritual teacher too.
I think so.
You know, and then people rapping and too, like, you know, they say, oh, they're going to hell. Some Christian might say that, straight Christian, like, they're using God's name in vain and they're cursing and this and that. But then again, rappers up on stage saying the F word and talking about sex and getting their dick sucked or whatever. You know, we're going to put it all out in front of you here. Put it all out on the, you know, it's just a word. You know, and all this, but no, they're going to hell. You know, no. They could be spiritual teachers too. They're sitting there. They might unknowingly be doing spiritual teaching in their words and not even know it.
Yeah, they're sexual healing or something.
Yeah, that's a spiritual teaching.
Yeah.
You know, it's
sexual healing. You know?
That's sexual healing.
Subject we could talk
about. That's an idea too.
Yeah.
Sexual healing. Yeah, that's a good. Let me get this video here because we're about to hit 20
Turn
minutes.
Turn by Marvin Gaye.
Yeah. Marvin, I'll put the link to the Marvin Gaye video up too, because Marvin Gaye's come through before. We had some interesting conversations with him, and you know, we taped one of them back in December. We got a minute left. I just wanted to comment about the Marvin Gaye one, because I didn't put a link up on Facebook yet to it. You know, some of them might not know it's on the YouTube page, but that's the interesting dude right there. I like Marvin. Good, real loving spirit. So, all right, we'll close this one out, and then we'll be doing part 3 in just a few minutes.